Good evening, Wildcat fans, and welcome to the Coach's Corner. I'm here with Coach Jeff Herron of the Camden County Wildcats. And Coach, as we enter into the 2010 season, having won the state 5A championship last year in Georgia, what was your thought process as you put together your schedule this year?
Well, you know, we were certainly wanting to try to three-peat. There's no question of that. And something we've never done before. So, you know, our kids have been really focused on that. And, you know, when we were trying to do our schedule, we were trying to get the most attractive matchups we could that would excite our fans, excite our kids, excite the coaches. And, you know, we only had two games to deal with this year outside of our region, but we were able to get two really good teams to come in here, one coming here and us going to St. Thomas. So we feel like the schedule certainly will help us toward our quest to three-peat. Might not help us right off the bat, but we think it'll help us in the long run.
And I'll take you back to a conversation that you and I had back in 2001. You had just came to Camden County. We went 8-2 the first year, lost the first round of the playoffs. The second year, we went 10-0, lost the first round of the playoffs. And you had a conversation with me about our kids need to be taken out of their comfort zone. We need to take them into an element that they're not familiar with and challenge them to perform. I would think with St. Thomas Aquinas and Miami Central and three state championships since then, you've accomplished that goal.
Well, I thought that our kids, you know, after being around them for a year or two, I thought they played very well when we played people they were familiar with. And you know, they felt comfortable that they could compete with. But I felt like when we got in the playoffs and we played somebody that they didn't know, that you know, we just didn't handle that well. We didn't handle that pressure well. So, excuse me, one of the things that we tried to do was to get them to play people they were unfamiliar with. And you know, that started out by trying to go to Valdosta to scrimmage. Took them to a weightlifting meet at Valdosta, and I can still remember our kids' eyes when we walked into the building. But you know, that got us over the hump, I think, and you know, we've continued to do that and to look for the ways. So, you know, I don't think our kids now are fazed by anybody in the state of Georgia. You know, they feel like they can compete with anybody. So what we're trying to do now is find some teams that, you know, they don't know something about, and again, to try to put them in those situations.
And as we talk about this opening of the season 2010, we opened up with the Savannah High Blue Jackets. I would think it would be a good game to get under your belt, just to kind of get everybody's feet wet before you take on a national power such as Miami Central.
Well, Bruce, you know, and working there at the rec department, there's always a lot of things you don't expect to happen early in the season that do. And, you know, we had a scrimmage with Charlton, and we made a million mistakes, you know, in terms of how we walked into the stadium, to which gate we used, to having trash cans in the locker room, to, you know, a million things that weren't related to the actual scrimmage. Well, we tried to correct that, get a lot of it done, so we only made about 500,000 by the time the first game rolled around. So we're hopefully getting closer, and you know, again, those were both the scrimmage certainly in the Savannah game, you know, hopefully helped us fix some areas, and we won't have as many of those type issues this week.
All right. And we'll be right back with some highlights from the Savannah High Blue Jackets and the Camden County Wildcats. We'll be right back. Coach, we got Miami Central coming to town Friday night. Talk a little bit about the team and the scouting report.
Well, Miami Central is an extremely good football team, and we've been very impressed with them in the film we saw from last year. And you know, I told you earlier, Bruce, USA Today's got them ranked second in the country, and I think that they might have underestimated them, to be honest with you. You know, a great athletic team with probably 7, 8, 9 kids that have already committed to Division I schools. They were good last year, got beat in the state semifinals, but they're probably even better this year. They've had a quarterback transfer in that led all of Broward County in passing last year, and the leading receiver in Broward County transfer to their school, not to mention a kid that, a kicker that's just phenomenal that transferred this summer. So, you know, take what they had last year, add those kids to it, and they've got a phenomenal football team. Very big, very fast, very physical. And, you know, I told a newspaper guy earlier this week that, you know, I really believe they're going to be the most talented team that's ever set foot on Chris Gilman Stadium.
And the significant challenge for the Wildcats, second game in the season, but that falls right back into your program by design of putting a challenge on these kids.
Well, you know, I would much rather play them later in the year, no question, you know, when we've had a chance to kind of get all the kinks worked out. But, you know, it is going to do what we thought, you know, we needed to do, which is get our kids out of that comfort zone. And, you know, it's a bigger challenge than I might have thought when we first scheduled it. But, you know, our kids are, again, they're used to the challenges, and I think they're going to respond well. They've, you know, during the course of the week, we've talked about the game and the magnitude of it and all the fans that are going to be here and all that, and it is going to be a huge game. But we don't always get that week in and week out, and we need it, and we need to find out where we're at. And, you know, so I think we're going to be ready to play. Our kids have never disappointed me in that regard, and I don't think they will this time. But it is a formidable task. Miami Central's got a great team, well-coached, and, you know, we'll see. You know, they're traveling up here and all that, and you know, hopefully that and our fans will play a big part in it.
And a big sponsor for the game with Miami Central, always a big night at the stadium, U.S. Army's coming in.
The U.S. Army's done a great job for us the last couple of years, and we always have game night sponsors, but they picked this game. They were the first ones to come on board this year and picked a good game to do it. So I think we have a general coming in to do some stuff pregame, and I think they're going to have tanks there and all kinds of stuff like that, and so it should add a lot to the festivities.
All right, this Friday night, 7:30 p.m., Chris Gilman Stadium, the Camden County Wildcats will take on Miami Central Rockets. Be there.